Darren Vaught here with the newly named 2022 USA Baseball Collegiate National Team coach, manager. It is Mike Bianco of Ole Miss. Mike, we're so excited to have you back. I know you've got some experience with the Collegiate National Team as the pitching coach back in 2013. Let's start here. Just very generally, what does it mean to you to have this honor?
Well, it is an honor, and yeah, it's humbling. And as you mentioned, Darren, I did this back in 2013, and I look back at that experience, and you know what a for me personally, what a cool time it was. But you know, to put the uniform on, and I think you know people say it all the time. Anytime they put USA across your chest, you know it's a special time, a special moment, and it is humbling. But somebody that's now 54 years old, that's you know coached for you know 30 plus years of college baseball, you know you're still you know kind of in awe and humbled and to be a part of such a great organization. I remember back in 13, you know, putting a uniform on, you know, as the pitching coach and being around guys like Trey Turner and Alex Bregman and Carlos Rodon. And man, I look back at that team and, you know, we knew they were great players, but man, you're talking about future Hall of Famers and just the history of USA baseball, not just in my, you know, one summer there, you know, eight, you know, plus years ago, but just, you know, the history, remembering back that I coached and played for Skip Bertman. And, you know, he was the Olympic pitching coach in 1988 and coached USA baseball. He was a collegiate national team manager in 95 and 96, and watching how much, arguably the greatest college baseball coach of all time, how much it meant to him, you know, and how excited he was. So, again, I guess the best word is humbled, and that I am.
Well, you mentioned some other stops on your resume. You're, of course, entering your 22nd season at Ole Miss. I mean, a couple more good seasons, Mike, and you're going to be creeping up on 1,000 career wins. Where would you say this stacks up? Can you place it at all in a type of hierarchy, being the U.S. Wow. the Team USA manager?
You know, I think it's hard. And I think, you know, the longer you go in life, right, it's hard. You don't want to pick your favorite kid. You know, you don't want to pick, you know, it's hard to pick those moments, but certainly one, like I still remember 13, like it was yesterday. So sometimes, you know, I think that's how you rate them, right? The things that you remember over time and the things that are so vivid and kind of etched in your brain. And, you know, and I know this will be. You know, and I think when it happens, obviously it's a little surreal, and you're just trying to do the best you can and do a good job for USA Baseball and for these great you know young athletes, and hopefully it'll be an experience like it was for me for them. You know that they'll be able to look back at their career and say, "Man, I remember playing for USA Baseball. What a neat experience it was!" And so I'm sure that I'll look back at one day and know feel probably more humbled and more honored than I feel today.
Going back to you serving as the team's pitching coach in 2013, what were your expectations heading in? Do you recall that time sort of that not? Was there anybody in your life that had sort of given you a heads up, hey, it's going to be like this or anything like that?
Well, I was, you know, I think a lot of people think it's you know, maybe not this way, but, you know, I was scared. I was like, you know, okay, you got, you know, these are the best guys that our country has to offer, best players. And you know, you do that every day and on your team, but you have some really good ones and you have some guys that, you know, next year are going to be accountants or engineers. And, you know, these are all future big leaguers. These are all future first rounders. And it's a little intimidating. And I remember talking to Jim Schlossnagel, who was the pitching coach back, I want to say maybe 06, 07, somewhere in there. And, you know, he was the pitching coach when David Price was on the team and others. And you kind of, you know, try to ask for some advice and how to do some things. And I know as I go forward, I'm going to probably reach back out to him and other guys that were the manager and what, you know, what things to expect, guys like, you know, Jim, guys like Dan McDonald and others, you know, Paul Maneri, you know, what advice that they could give you to make sure that, you know, it's not only a great experience for me, but it's also a great experience for the student athlete.
I'm going to stay on that 13 team for one more question, Mike, because you started to list off some of the guys on that roster. I'm looking at it now. You mentioned Alex Bregman, Matt Chapman, Michael Conforto were on that team. A number of other guys, Carlos Rodon, Kyle Schwarber, Trey Turner, also of NC State. Do you have a memory distinctly of at the time? Again, you said you knew they were good players, but I would imagine as a coach, I mean, you have really good teams at Ole Miss, but it's not like this is an all-star team, right? Compiled of right. players from all over the country. Do you have a recollection of walking in for the first practice or the first workout and just being like, wow, in terms of this is the best collection of talent as a coach I've seen?
Yeah. Well, as you're asking that long question, you know, one of the things
keep me accountable, you know, I got to, you know, my job's, I'm supposed to keep them short, Mike. So yeah. I like that.
One of the things that I remember about that it always sticks out. And as I share with, you know, other coaches, I shared with my assistant, as you go through that collection of names and who's who of all stars now and probably future big leaguers. I remember our very first game. I want to say it was in somewhere in Virginia. We were making the Coastal Plains Tour League. We had just gotten to the hotel. I had my first pitching meeting kind of like in a breakfast area at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, meeting these guys for the first time, watching their videos for the last year, but meeting them for the first time. And Weaver was supposed to start that game. And I remember it was raining that day, and we weren't sure, and it didn't look like we were going to play. I mean, it was just pouring. And I remember Schloss coming in and said, hey, Eric says, you know, we need to try to get it in. They're going to postpone the game like an hour and a half. They got like 3,000 people. They sold the tickets. It's a big thing for the city. And I remember going, and I remember the bullpen. The field was okay. They had a tarp on it. Now, there was a lot of standing water and the foul areas. But I remember the bullpen literally just being an island, you know, where there was clay and then water around it, where when I got there and watching Weaver warm up, I mean, it was – this guy's going to pitch in the big leagues like in another couple of years. And, you know, not that it was risky like injury, but, you know, the conditions that, you know, he had to jump over giant puddles just to get to the bullpen. And he never said a word, never complained. That none of those guys, and we ran a lot of guys to the bullpen that night that had to jump over the puddles and do those things. And I guess the part, you know, that I'm trying to get at is these guys are future big leaguers. You know, these guys that probably and should have your tremendous ego, set that all aside, because this is their first game, you know, wearing the uniform and what it meant. And nobody dared complain or, you know, look at these, you know, this situation and jumping over puddles and being in small, you know, dirty dugouts. They didn't ever worry about that. And through that whole tour, we never heard any complaints. And the other thing that sticks out in my mind was about Bregman and Turner, where they were both college shortstops and both arguably the two best shortstops, you know, in the country. And we had a little concerned if they would be able to handle it, like, because one's going to play second, one's going to play short. We just didn't know which ones were. And I remember Schloss talking to both of them and said, hey, listen, we're going to let you guys battle it out, but then we're going to pick one. And are you guys all right with that? And both of them said, yeah, I'll play wherever you want me to, coach. I just want to be on this team and I want to help us, you know, succeed. And so when those guys, you know, the guys that are the future of Major League Baseball can put away their egos, can put away, you know, what, you know, kind of they've dealt with the last few years in the draft and all of that, and do it, you know, for the USA national team, that was special for me to see those guys kind of be great teammates and really compete for the name on the front rather than the name on the back. I thought that was really cool.
Yeah. I should mention Luke Weaver of Florida State. We didn't even mention, and he's the guy you talk about starting that game. Yeah. I mean, an incredible pitcher at Florida State. It's so easy to overlook a really good player that was on this roster. Between 2013, your time with the Collegiate National Team, and now, you've had several players get named to and play for the Collegiate National Team. Most recently, you've got Hayden Dunhurst and Jacob Gonzalez, who were with the team last summer, guys like Doug Nicasey. After 2013 and your experience with the team, did you have anything to offer them in terms of what to expect whenever you would have a player represent Team USA?
You know, I haven't had, you know, great conversations with them because they've been easy ones. I mean, it's such, you know, to tell them that, you know, Eric Campbell, the general manager for the collegiate national team, is going to give them a call this afternoon and, you know, invite them to carry, you know, for, you know, to be part of, you know, this great experience, you know, they've all been, you know, super flattered. I can only imagine as, you know, as a young person, even at a guy that's, has the talent of the guys that you've already mentioned throughout this to get that call to say that, hey, you know, they're considering me to be one of these team members, one of the 12 position players or one of the 12 pitchers on the USA national team's roster. What an honor, you know, that's got to be to get that call from Eric and all our guys, you know, throughout my years and through my 22 years from Seth Smith and Lance Lynn to most recently Jacob Gonzalez and Hayden Dunhurst and Derek Diamond. You know, when those guys get that call, I mean, I think they're just super flattered and, you know, it's a dream come true.
Here comes another long question, but I promise I've got a point because there's a story that goes with it, and it includes Hayden. So Hayden is a catcher for you, obviously caught for the collegiate national team this past summer. And our last bus ride, because I traveled with the team and got to know them relatively well throughout that stretch, our last bus ride, I overheard a conversation between he and Landon Sims of Mississippi State. I mean, heated rivals, right? Once you get into the SEC season. And it was after their final game before playing some tune-up games against the U.S. Olympic team in Cary. And Landon seeks out Hayden on the bus and smacks him on the shoulder and says something along the lines of, well, I guess we got to go back to hating each other now, right? And they both laugh and it starts this conversation about, you know, Landon looks over at Kyle Teal from Virginia and he was like, man, I kind of hated you before this whole thing, right? Just based off of what I had seen, what I had heard, stuff like that. But like, we're brothers now, we're teammates now. That's always, to me, one of the coolest elements of the collegiate national team. From your perspective as manager, is there anything you can do to help that? Or do you
part of, I think, that first week is getting them to become a team. You know, one of the things that we don't want it to be is just an all-star team. Right. You know, just you're selected and it's honor. And, you know, it doesn't matter if you win or lose. It's just, you know, to be selected to the all-star team is a great thing. You know, so we've talked a little bit here about what an honor it is, but we also want to win. Right. And we also want to have success. And to do that, you know, they have to buy into it. They bought into it. They all buy into it, you know, on a collegiate level. And it's a lot easier when you're the coach at Ole Miss because we have them for a whole semester. And we talk about teamsmanship and we do those team bonding type things. I think that's the big challenge is to get them to become a team very, very quickly. And it's not supposed to happen at a Major League All-Star game or obviously a Pro Bowl in the NFL. This is different. This is an all-star collection of talented collegiate players that are coming together for a common goal, right? You know, to represent your country in the best fashion. And so I think that's really a task of, you know, not only myself, but Eric and the entire staff of USA Baseball to get these guys to not only perform well on the field, but our game's different. You know, you don't just outman them, right? You got to play better than them. And it's such a small window that we always say that it's not the best team that always wins. It's the team that plays the best. And the team that plays the best is really, you know, the best team. And that's what we need. I think the task of us that first week in Cary.
How much do you pay attention to college baseball outside of your tunnel vision SEC season, trying to get Ole Miss in the best position possible and to win as many games as possible? Because I ask because guys like Elliot Avent of NC State, who was the collegiate national team manager last year, Dan McDonald of Louisville, you mentioned already a few years ago, they both mentioned to me, yeah, I didn't really watch a lot of West Coast college baseball, but knowing I was going to be responsible for selecting this team, I found myself paying a lot more attention. Do you envision yourself doing that?
100%. And now that's a challenge for me. You know, everybody's different and everybody has different hobbies. I have five children. So my five children really have been my hobbies for the last 22 years. And just to try to, once I'm done here, I go home and try to be the dad. And this is not trying to throw stones at anybody, but you know, I miss enough stuff. I've missed, you know, three or four graduations, and I miss proms, and I miss all these different events during the spring. And so I've never been the huge social media guy. I've never been the, you know, that, you know, it's hard. Sometimes I don't know who the best player in, you know, the Big 12 is, or the, you know, the Pac 12 or the ACC, certainly some other, you know, smaller conferences that may not get the media coverage. So that's a challenge for me. And it was a challenge in 13. But you know, Eric and his staff does such a great job of getting you the information of that watch list and watching videos and getting stats, but you kind of got to get in that mode. It's in that recruiting mode. And I think a lot of times as head coaches, those coaches were talking about, that, you know, you kind of got to be in that recruiting mode to where you got to know the names, you got to know who's good, and you got to watch them, because, you know, you're making some big decisions. And so again, I'm looking forward to it. I was probably a little more intimidated in 13 because I am like that. I think, you know, like Dan and, you know, Elliot, I think I'm kind of like, hey, you just put the blinders on, coach your team, and the rest will take care of itself. We'll figure it out. We just want to get to Omaha. We'll figure out who the other seven teams when we get there. Right. And so I think that's a big, you know, kind of a test for all the head coaches that are part of this, is to get back to that mode, because you want to pick the best guys. They deserve to be the, you know, our time and our effort through the next few months to watch, you know, their greatness on the field.
Yeah. This is my last question for you. And I say this because players tell me all the time, they make a Team USA team, whether it be at the 12U level, the 15U level, 18U, collegiate team, Olympic team, what have you, and their baseball careers going afterward, they, as it's been described to me by some, they carry around an extra armor. It's a layer of confidence that they move on with. For Mike Bianco, a coach who's been in it for decades at this point, being named the collegiate national team manager, are you gonna have a little bit more armor headed into this spring in 2022?
You know, I don't know if it's armor, but I also know that, you know, once you wore the uniform, you know, the uniform, as we even tell our Ole Miss guys, it never comes off. You know, I think you're part of a fraternity. You're part of a collection of individuals. So guys like Bregman and Turner and Rodon and Weaver and all those guys, they'll have that moment, you know, that, you know, month that they spent with USA Baseball over in Japan and across our country, and those great memories. But they also wore the uniform, so they're part of that fraternity, you know, the guys that were before him and now the guys that are after him. And I think as coaches, I think it's the same thing. I mean, I look at all the great coaches. I mentioned Coach Burman and, you know, Tim Corbin and Dan McDonald and Elliot Avan and all the great ones. To be part of that fraternity is really an honor and really, you know, a neat thing for me.
Well, as you have been since 2013, you're a member of the fraternity, the family here at USA Baseball, as we call it. We know you've got a couple of guys on roster there at Ole Miss that are the same way. So we wish you and them the best of luck heading into this spring. And we'll see you this summer in Cary.
Thanks so much, Darren. I appreciate it.